Welcome to Werthstein. I'm Giles Keating, chair of the Werthstein Institute, and I'm here with my colleagues Valerie Plagnol, Stefan Risser, and Christine Shields. Valerie, to get us going, one word on what's been going on, the crucial thing going on in the world economy.
My word, Giles, it's Japan. I was there just a month ago, and I can tell you, it's really changing.
Stefan.
My phrase is fait accompli, because a Brexit now is a fait accompli. And as always, fait accomplis are not relevant for the markets.
Christine.
My word is politics. I think there's more political uncertainty around in the world now than in my lifetime.
And my word is expanding, since that's what the world economy has done since our last show. Later, we'll look at two zeitgeists you might consider investing in, both of them major themes which we think will grow faster than the general economy: robotics and Internet 4.0, and we'll vote to choose one. But for now, what's the evidence for continued global expansion? The US is adding jobs, consumers there are buoyant, and investment is surprised to the upside. Europe has had some mixed signals from business surveys, but Germany's GDP rose faster than its quarter century average. And overall, we think both the Eurozone and the UK are on track for reasonable growth despite Brexit. In Asia, Japan is lagging, but China's retail sales are healthy, still rising in double digits, which is much faster than elsewhere. And oil prices in August rebounded to around $50, well clear of the sub-40 danger zone that threatens financial strains on producers. And yet it's still low enough to leave consumers with good purchasing power. Reflecting this good global economy, financial markets have tended to rise further. Some US equity indices have touched new all-time highs. At Werthstein, we still see investment opportunities, especially in the zeitgeist that capture those fast-growing parts of the economy. However, the rally in markets does mean that prices are not quite as attractive as they were a month ago. The Fed has started hinting again at the possibility of a small US interest rate rise before the end of the year. Now look, so far this hasn't unsettled investors, but we do think it increases the possibility of a temporary stock market correction. And growing political uncertainty around the world points to the same risk. If there is a correction, I think it's likely to represent a good moment for accelerating investment into portfolios rather than holding back. But does the panel agree? Stefan.
So, as you know, I'm very optimistic for the stock market. I pointed that out in our last show, and I'm still there. But so where I not agree with you is on the US economy. I think the European economy is stronger than the US economy, because there'd be good labor market reports, that's right, but the GDP growth is not very high. There had been a lot of leading indicators what were disappointing in the end. And you have to see the budget deficit is again much than 4%. So that's all bought by new deficits. And in my mind, this growth in the US is not healthy. It will go on, I think. It will not bother the stock market in the moment, but we have to have an eye on it.
Christine, what do you think?
Well, I agree that the US performance has been disappointing so far, but I think there's a very good chance of an upturn in the second half, which will leave the year as a whole with half-decent growth, which is obviously positive. I think the world economy needs a fiscal stimulus because, you know, the problem since the global financial crisis, actually, has been that growth almost everywhere has been really quite slow, and it's certainly not gone back to pre-crisis trends. So I think a fiscal stimulus wouldn't go amiss, actually, to try and lift us out of where we are.
You were just in Japan, Valerie. What's going on there?
Well, that's one of my questions. I mean, I'm more confident in the real economy than I am in governments and central banks, for that matter. And Christine, I know there is a sense that we need to have some fiscal stimulus. The problem, what kind of fiscal stimulus should we get? And I'm afraid the direction it is taking is not exactly the one we want, because it's just adding debt to debt and forcing central bank to intervene even further in that particularly dangerous kind of cycle where Japan is well ahead the rest of the world. So my optimism on the real economy stands away from what governments are actually doing. So I'm very cautious. There is a lot to do on infrastructure. I'm not sure they're taking the right move at this moment.
I suspect probably what's needed in much of Europe, certainly, is small-scale infrastructure investments. UK being a case in point, better do localised smaller projects than these great big mega projects, which are the sort that are being proposed.
Stefan, do you think we're going to get that?
So we have to see. So I criticised in the German press our finance minister very hard, saying it is crazy if you get interest rates by borrowing you money, because it's negative also for 10 years, to be fixed on these zero debt. So you have to do debts to invest in infrastructure, in education. I think they're missing that, and they're having a very big chance in the moment to do this. So I agree with you. We need fiscal stimulation, but it shows again we need it everywhere in the world, with the exception of Germany, so that the economy economies are growing, and that shows. Yeah, we are in a situation where we not know how this experiment with this enormous expansion of the money supply will end. But as long as the party goes, you have to dance.
Well, let's just come back to that. Valerie, what's your view on the markets now?
Well, I'm very cautious right now. I mean, I was pretty much optimistic. I think we had a very nice summer and a very good rally. But right now, I mean, September, October, I feel much more cautious. A lot of political issues are coming up. Of course, mentioning the U.S. election, for one, is really tricky. You mentioned the Fed. I tend to agree with you. The speech by President Yellen was very clear in many respects, and I'm not sure the market is taking it right where it is.
I really actually agree with you, because, I mean, I actually think the U.S. economy, contrary perhaps to Stefan, I'm sort of okay with it, more, Christine, I think, in your line. But I think because of that, the Fed is going to go ahead and raise rates fairly soon. And I don't think that's a disaster for markets, but I think it can cause some short-term unsettling. I mean, Christine.
Yeah, I mean, I suspect the Fed may very well hike in September, actually, which could be a shock to markets. And I think, as always with markets and politics, they very often don't actually see the risks till it hits them in the face. And then there is a sharp correction, and that's what I worry about.
All right. Well, lots of risks around, but also opportunities. Before we actually move to the vote, I'd like each of the panel to just give a quick summary of what they think the outlook is for the markets over the next several months. Valerie.
Well, Jaz, as I told you, I mean, I'm a long-term optimist. Right now, I'm very cautious. I feel much more comfortable for staying put and knowing better what's going to happen in the coming months.
Stefan.
So what happens since our last show is a big confirmation for me, because I was a big optimist in our panel, and the stock markets did exactly that. They rise, and I think that's just the start of a big stock market rally, not because I see a big expansion in the old industrial countries, but because the undervaluation of the equities in comparison to the bonds.
Christine.
Well, as always, I'm more cautious than Stefan, particularly. I share Valerie's view, really. I'm concerned about the short term. I'll be happier once we've got through the election period next autumn, next year. Once we've got to that point, then I might be a bit more optimistic.
Thank you. And in my view, well, I think there are big risks here. And I think I'm probably particularly worried about the Fed, perhaps even more than I am about the effect of politics. Well, now let's move to the actual vote. Remember, it's between 0 and 10. 0 is most pessimistic, 10 most optimistic. Valerie, please kick us off.
Well, Charles, this time it's a 4.
Stefan.
So for me, it's an 8.
Christine.
For me, it's a 3.
And for me, it's a 4. So if we put that together, that's 19. That's a lot more cautious than the last Werthstein vote. So now let's think about how we actually invest. And in the second half of the show, we're going to be looking at zeitgeists, which could be ways to actually invest in the stock market.